Now let's calculate the standard free energy of reaction for, again, the same equation, 25 degrees Celsius. And it does say use the definition. So in any problem that says use the definition, that means use the mathematical definition. In other words, delta G equals delta H minus T delta S. The free energy change equals the enthalpy change minus the temperature times the entropy change. In order to do this, we need to have delta H, T, and delta S. We calculated the standard enthalpy of reaction for this reaction earlier. It was minus 835.8 kilojoules. We also calculated the standard entropy change for this reaction. It was minus 168.8 joules per Kelvin. So put those together along with the temperature, and we can get the standard free energy change, or the standard free energy of reaction. So delta G equals delta H, minus 835.8 kilojoules, minus the temperature, has to be in Kelvin. If anything, you should remember that because the entropy units are joules per Kelvin. So 25, the shift is 273.15, and since 25 Celsius goes to no decimal places, I'll round my Kelvin to no decimal places. So let's see, delta G, equals delta H minus T times delta S times the minus 168.8 joules per Kelvin. And then we just put those together. Do you see a problem? Well, you should. We've got kilojoules for the enthalpy, and we've got joules in the entropy. So we need to get them all in the same units, and let's just put them all in kilojoules. So 1,000 joules per kilojoule. Now, watch your negatives again. That can be tricky. So the standard free energy of reaction is minus 785.5 kilojoules. The negative means it's exergonic, and it means it is spontaneous. You know, if you looked at your standard enthalpy of reaction, that was a negative 835.8, which is exothermic, which appears to suggest that the reaction is spontaneous. And the standard entropy change was minus 168.8 joules per Kelvin. But that seems to suggest that the reaction's non-spontaneous. Well, you can't take simply the enthalpy sign and the entropy sign. You can't take one of them and figure out whether it's spontaneous. You have to look at delta G. The negative sign tells you it is spontaneous.